Let's talk a little bit about soil. Now, this is sand. Sand, if you try to plant tomatoes in sand, doesn't work very well, does it? And here I have something that you would just call clods of dirt. If you just try to grow tomatoes in dirt, you might get them started, but they're not going to thrive. What you need is good quality soil. Soil, even though we sometimes use it interchangeably with the word dirt, soil is different. Soil promotes the healthy growth of plants. And yes, different plants have different things that they need to grow and thrive, but there are some basic ingredients that all good soil has. So I have here some potting soil. And the potting soil, if I scoop out a cup of it, you see that it has a very rich, dark color. And it's very loose. Now, the instructions for using the soil properly are on the back of the bag. So it tells you how to plant in a planter. And so you can't read this, I'll read it to you. It says, place the plant in the pot with the roots well spread out. Add the soil mix up to a half inch from the rim and compact gently. Very important. Water thoroughly. Once the plant is established, fertilize periodically. That tells you something about what good soil has to have. You pat gently because you need to trap air within the soil to get to the plant roots. You need to water it thoroughly and every so often because the plant roots need water. So two of the important things that good soil has to have is air and water. Also notice that it says to fertilize periodically. So plants not only need air and water, they also need nutrients. And these nutrients come in two overall classes. The first is minerals. Just like you need your vitamins and minerals, so do plants. And so you can put the fertilizer on, which has the minerals that the plants need. Another thing you can do is you can let Mother Nature do its thing. You can do what's called rotating crops. You can plant crops that have different nutritional needs, one after the other after another. And if you pair up or triple up the right kinds of crops, the nutrients that one need are provided by that previous generation of crops. So rotating crops is a good way to keep from depleting the soil of its nutrients. Another thing that you can do is you can leave a field fallow. That means just don't plant anything in it and let nature take over. Right? But again, what most people do is the brute force method of fertilizing, of putting nutrients back into the soil. Now, it's not just these minerals that the plants need. They also need decayed organic material, what we call humus. Humus, H-U-M-U-S. Do not confuse that with hummus, H-U-M-M-U-S. Hummus, you put on crackers. Very delicious. Humus, do not put on crackers. Not delicious. Now, the kind of humus that you use depends upon sometimes your secret family recipe for growing good tomatoes. Your grandpa may have always told you to only use chicken manure, or perhaps a compost heap material, or perhaps dead fish. Any decayed organic material, plant or animal, will count as humus. Again, different kinds of plants have different nutritional needs, so a particular kind of humus might be best suited to a particular kind of plant. But again, to review, healthy soil needs air, needs water, needs minerals, and needs humus.